afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Acherno Arena at the Bob Carpenter Center for today's NCAA women's basketball game between the Bucknell University Bison and your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. Fans, at this time, please welcome the honorary coach for today's game, Mrs. Lee Wainwright. Previously named the 2014 Delaware Teacher of the Year, she is not only a praised French teacher at Appaquinimink High School, but a lead mentor outside the classroom for new teachers, in addition to helping develop statewide teacher evaluation measures, coaching lacrosse, and volunteering in the community. A passionate season ticket holder with her husband, George, she is honored to be a part of the Blue Hens team this afternoon. Let's give a big round of applause and welcome today's honorary guest coach, Mrs. Lee Wainwright. Starting lineups first for the visiting Bison of Bucknell University. At guard, a junior from Columbus, Ohio, number 3, Tyler Craig. At guard, a junior from Darwin, Australia, number 4, Claire Marie O'Brien. At guard, a sophomore from Westchester, Pennsylvania, number 11, Megan McGurk. At forward, a sophomore from Grove Point, Michigan, number 12, Claire DeBoer. And at forward, a senior from Vienna, Virginia, number 44, Audrey Dotson. Director of Basketball Operations is Brittany Marshall. Assistant coaches are LaTanya Watson, Mike Lane, and Katie Adams. Head coach for the Bison is Aaron Russell. And now for your University of Delaware, Fight Blue Hens. At guard, a junior from Winchester, Virginia, number 2, Courtney Green. At guard, a sophomore from Allen, New Jersey, number 3, Erica Brown. At forward, a freshman from North Babylon, New York, number 5, Makeda Nicholas. At forward, a sophomore from St. John's, Newfoundland, Canada, number 12, Hannah Jardine. And at center, a senior from Northport, New York, number 33, Stephanie Leo. Director of Basketball Operations is Allie Tilley. The assistant coaches are Tara Malcolm and Tom Lochner. Associate head coach, Jenny Renice. And in her 19th season as head coach of the Blue Hens, Tina Martin.
Backcourt features Tyler Craig with Claire Marie O'Brien as their leading scorer, 12 points, 5 boards per game. The swing player, Claire DeBoer, 6'1 sophomore, who averages a double-double, 10 points, 10 rebounds per contest. The other guard, Megan McGurk, 8 points, 4 rebounds per game, and Audrey Dotson is the center. Meanwhile, for Delaware, the point guard, Erica Brown, Courtney Green, the off guard, the three-player, Hannah Jardine, power forward, Makeda Nicholas, and the center is Steph Leo. Hens will move from left to right in the opening half. They wear the home white jerseys, and they win the tip as Steph Leone back taps it to Erica Brown. We are underway for the Carpenter Center in Newark. Leone dribbling the ball to the forecourt for UD, handing it off top of the circle, Hannah Jardine. Left wing chest pass over to Courtney Green. High screen from Nicholas. Instead, she drives baseline to the foul line. Leone, near corner feed to Brown, trying to drive towards the tin. Too strong off the window. Ball volleyballed around on the rebound try. Out of bounds, last touch by UD. And it belongs to Bucknell, 24 seconds into the game, still scoreless. Bucknell wearing navy blue row jerseys, white numbers, white letters spelling out Bucknell in caps across the chest, and orange trim on the sides of the uniforms. They have the ball in the forecourt, top of the circle with it for the Bison, O'Brien. She'll feed left wing to McGurk. McGurk walked as she drove to the foul line, picked up her bounce and dragged the pivot foot. And that gives it back to UD, who's not the prettiest of offensive starts for either team. Hens will walk the ball into the forecourt. Erica Brown running point guard. Bucknell falling back, half-court man-to-man defensive look. Brown top of the circle as Bucknell switches off a high screen. Feeds to Leon left wing. Hand off to Green there. Thought about a three, instead puts it on the deck. Crossover move into the lane. Finds a flashing Makeda Nicholas who front rims a 12-foot straightaway jumper. And it's one and done for the Hens. O'Brien the rebound. Brings it forward. Lobs it into the paint. Turnaround hook. Dotson had her shot blocked. Got it back. Follow wouldn't go. Offensive rebound. DeBoer. DeBoer kicks it outside and Bucknell will reset. Fresh 30, 18:48 left in the opening half, and we're scoreless. Driving baseline, far side of the floor. It's Dotson out to O'Brien for three straight away. Wouldn't go. Nicholas the rebound, and here come the Hens. Outlets it forward to Brown. Brown driving to the foul line. Right wing dish to Jardine. Puts it on the deck with the left hand. Near corner chest pass to Brown. Brown right wing feed to Green. Green calls for a high screen. Gets it. Tries to turn the corner off of it. Drives to the elbow. Far corner feed to Jardine who hits the three. Hannah Jardine off the pass from Courtney Green. Hens on the board first.
And Hannah Jardine continuing what we saw her do. When she's ready and she's set, she catches that pass. She's on every time.
DeBoer driving into the lane for Bucknell, spinning on Leon. Off balance shot, one go. Nobody gets the ball for Delaware. DeBoer gets it back. Dishes to Craig. Outside, left wing feed to McGurk. Finds a wide open O'Brien who misses the triple and Green the weak side rebound. Courtney brings it up for UD. Into the forecourt, dribbling in front of the Bucknell bench. Hesitates at the wing, now driving into the lane. Near corner feed to Brown. Brown off two dribbles. Stop and pop. Jumper wouldn't go. Just right of the lane. Long rebound chased down by Bucknell. Here comes McGurk into the forecourt. Finds a trailing Dotson. Head fake to three and got Leon off balance. And Steph gives the contact. That's her first foul. And something to keep an eye on. Leon got into foul trouble in the first half against Temple. Had to sit, and that's when Delaware started to struggle. And as a result, to avoid the early foul trouble, Leon will sit down. As will Erica Brown. Sawyer into the game. Caracciolo in for Delaware. Inbound comes baseline right for Bucknell. It goes on a lob to DeBoer out near center court. Around the perimeter, right wing feed over to McGurk. McGurk feeds up top, wide open to DeBoer. DeBoer, left wing dish to O'Brien. A whistle and a turnover. A three-second violation against Bucknell gives it back to UD. Pretty solid half-court defensive start for the Hens.
It is, but one thing that we did see in the first couple possessions here defensively is Bucknell has two or three offensive rebounds so far in this game, something that the Hens need to limit.
Delaware up 3-0. Courtney Green trying to add to the edge. Straight away, three would not go. Back rim over the backboard. So out of bounds. It belongs to Bucknell. Just under 3 minutes in. And ends up 3-0. So Delaware trying to box out. Early change in the point guard spot. Sawyer in. Driving baseline for Bucknell. It's Craig. Craig dishes outside. Open O'Brien. Instead, she wants to go to the basket and is fouled on her way to the 10. See if it's in the act or shooting or on the floor. Nicholas gave the contact, and they will give continuation to Claire Marie O'Brien. She'll earn a trip to the line for a pair. 77% free throw shooter, Australian native, and has been red hot of late for this Bucknell team. Came off a career-high 20-point performance. Added six rebounds, three made three-pointers, and the victory over Morgan State. Hits the first free throw. She'll get one more. Bucknell on the board, 3:06 into the game. Second foul shot rattles home, and it's a 3-2 game. And first sub for Bucknell. Mickey Impoline Zaire into the game. She replaces Dotson. Here comes Delaware. Nicholas with the top of the circle. Left hand bounce towards the elbow. Hands it off to Green. Green got fouled as trying to reach in was Tyler Craig. And that'll keep possession with UD. And Enzel sub in freshman Chastity Taylor. See who she'll replace. It's going to be Nicholas who takes a seat for Delaware. 3-2, Hens on top, 16:42 to go in the first half. Also into the contest comes Shiera Jones. Jones replaces Craig. So like line changes right now, a lot of subs. We're less than 4 minutes into this contest and each team has gone eight deep. Sawyer with it, top of the circle, right wing feed to Jardine. Jardine looks for Craig. Craig with it towards the left side of the floor. Now dribbles towards the right wing. Up top to Jardine. Dribbling left elbow, being pawed at the whole way, and the foul comes on the floor. Jardine ended up going to the basket, laying it home with the left hand, but the contact came first. So wave off the basket. And a foul on Jones, her first.
And a great decision by Hannah Jardine. They know that now that she can shoot the three-point shot, so she's giving herself that option to be able to take the ball to the basket now.
She gets it in at the foul line. Right wing feed over to Green. Green drives baseline, blows by the defense. Help is late, and Green contorts to get the angle and finishes in tight. Courtney Green gives the Hens a 5-2 edge. Meanwhile, Bucknell tries to race it for Delaware back defensively. They have it inside, being doubled near the basket, Catherine Romain. And a whistle and a 3-second violation again called against Bucknell. So a very helter-skelter start offensively for the Bison.
And what a job by the Hens right there. We saw three Hens collapse on DeBoer inside the lane.
Sire, left wing feed over to Green, lobs it inside. Caracciolo powers up with a left hand and banks it home. And the Hens are up 7-2 early. Bucknell looking for an answer the other way. O'Brien up top to Impaline Zaire. Gives it to DeBoer. DeBoer left hand bounce to the foul line. Near corner feed O'Brien. Head fake and being fouled by Chastity Taylor. Hand checked the whole way. Official tried to hold off blowing the whistle, but eventually had to. And that'll take us to a timeout on the floor. Taylor's first, team's third. 15:34 remaining in the opening half. It's a 7-2 Delaware edge. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Hey fans, 12 and younger. Do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
I'm here because this is my home. Delaware Pride. You can say I have that. It's bigger now. The state is across my chest. Now it's about all of us. Now I am a Blue Hen. Experience it.
.15:34 to go in the opening half. Delaware 7, Bucknell 2. Strong start for the Hens defensively, really making Bucknell look out of sorts on the offensive end.
Yeah, and especially for the Hens right now offensively, we're seeing the points come from the outside and the inside. Courtney Green hitting a three. Joy Caracciolo and Hannah Jardine both getting to the basket.
Strong start on both ends of the floor. Bucknell with the basketball. The inbound lob to Jackie Klotz, who just checked it. Klotz feeds it up top to Impaline Zaire. She'll feed it left wing to Jones. Jones driving towards the paint. Taylor hacks at her, no call. Dishes outside, and Pauline Zaire walked as she went towards the lane. Dragged the back pivot foot, was a little indecisive. Delaware flashing into passing lanes. It seems to be bothering Bucknell.
Yeah, it's putting a lot of pressure on the Bucknell guards, and that's forcing them to make these decisions.
Hens ball up 5, 15-10 and ticking in the opening half. Jody Sawyer dribbling into the full court, just lost her handle, but got a big break as Tyler Craig tried to chase it down, stepped on the sideline as she stole the ball. So a reprieve for Sager, who's got to be a bit stronger with the handle. Coming off of a performance where she didn't get too many minutes against Temple, but two games ago played her best contest of the year against Vermont. Hannah Jardine's inbound pass looking for Sager. Tipped out of bounds, so the Hens will throw it in again. Athena Martin did not like that inbound pass, as it tells her team in no uncertain terms to run it a tad differently. They do this time. Into Sawyer out near center court, and then over to Green, who's bumped. Green fouled on the perimeter by Jackie Klotz. That's already the third team foul on Bucknell, just under 5 minutes in, first on Klotz. Inbound comes near sideline. Jardine gets it in to Sawyer. Looks back at her coach to call the play. Dribbling foul line right, high screen from Caracciolo, turning the corner left hand towards the top of the key. Right wing feed to Green, near corner to Jardine. Head fake, tried to drive baseline, had it stripped but got it back. Lobs it inside, good feed to Caracciolo. Can't finish in tight, got back her own miss and is tied up. Arrow will give it back to Bucknell. Great feed from Jardine. Good seal from Joyce. He's just got to finish in tight.
Yeah, and we talked about it in the Temple game about the post players for Delaware bringing the ball down. Joy dropped the ball right there. She's got to keep it up and go straight up and finish.
Here's Craig dribbling all the way to the basket. Nobody stops ball and lays it home. Now nobody wants to take the inbound pass. Delaware's going to have to use a timeout. Oh, my. They lay it home as Delaware late getting back, and then four players ran up the floor. Jody Sawyer underneath looking to throw it in and had nary a teammate in the area, was already at the three count and had to take a timeout. That won't make Tina Martin any happier.
I'm sure it's not. That's probably what they're hearing about right now in that timeout.
That's an unforced error or mistake. We saw the inbound pass earlier on the sideline where Hannah Jardine, instead of any sort of a fake, just throws it. Hens have had some issues getting the ball inbounds at stretches this season.
Yeah, and Bucknell right now, especially the guards, are putting a lot of pressure on the Delaware guards right now. So this is a time, this is a point that we've seen a lot of times this season where the Delaware guards get very frazzled, and that's where the bad decisions come into play. So it'll be interesting to see here what kind of decisions the Hen guards start making.
So Delaware having to take the timeout in the opening half, 5.5 minutes into this contest with a 7-4 lead. I'm still not sure the team is entirely aware of who should have taken that inbound pass. Some words, Jardine, Sawyer, and Joy Caracciolo kind of straightening it out as they break the huddle. New look out here lineup-wise for Delaware as Erica Brown will stay on the floor with Jody Sawyer. So both point guards in for the first time today. Sawyer bringing it up. She runs point Brown at the off-guard spot. Sawyer going straight to the basket. Got her shot blocked and hit off the side of the backboard, but she got it back. Good hustle by Sawyer to chase it down. Finds Brown. New reset of the shot clock. The ball never hit the tin. Brown driving towards the foul line. Left wing feed to Taylor. High post entry to Jardine. Left elbow turnaround jumper. Rattles home. Hit off every part of the rim, but fell. Hens by five. 14 minutes left of the first half. Bucknell racing it the other way. Jones near corner. Feeding up top. Off the bounce. Jumper for Klotz is good. Straight away creating off the dribble. And it's 9-6. Hens got to do a bit better job in transition. Bucknell racing everything up the floor. Here's Sawyer into the fourth court. Right wing bounce, lobbing inside. Caracciolo bumped and fouled. Impaline Zaire called for the personal. Her first, team's fourth. Steph Leone will return. Hannah Jardine takes a seat. So a bigger lineup here for Delaware. Both Caracciolo and Leone in on the front line. Taylor playing at the three, and then the two point guards in the backcourt. Sawyer inbounds it to her fellow point guard, Brown, who rises, fires, and hits. A little short baseline, Jay, right side of the floor. It's 11-6 UD.
And another good decision by Erica Brown, taking what the defense gave her there.
Up top in Pauline Zaire. Left wing feed over to Craig. Craig spinning her way into the lane. Good defense by Sawyer. Finds a teammate, though. Klotz straight away, point blank jumper, no. Taylor got the rebound, had it ripped away, and then commits a foul as Shiera Jones went straight up with it. That's a freshman mistake there. Chastity Taylor's got to be stronger with the ball, and she pays for it by picking up her second foul less than 7 minutes in.
Yeah, Chastity Taylor right there wanted to put the ball on the floor first. The coaches talk about constantly about catching, collecting yourself, turning and facing before you put the ball on the floor.
Jones hits the first free throw. Taylor will have to sit down, replaced by Courtney Green. Impaline Zaire goes out as well for Bucknell. DeBoer replacing her. Chastity Taylor, I mean, her foul per minute clip has to be almost one per every minute played. She's very good when she can stay out there, but she's having some problems with it in the early going. Sawyer grabbed the rebound on the missed free throw, drives towards the lane, picks up her bounce and walks. Didn't look like much of a move of that back pivot. She stares down the official a bit as she walks up the floor. Do you like that call, Lauren?
I didn't agree with it. I thought she kept both feet down, but.
Here's a three the other way from Klotz. Hits the triple. Delaware a little late closing out. And Bucknell to within one. You know, the nice part about sitting over here and not playing anymore, you're allowed to say stuff about the officials.
Yeah, true. I don't want it to be on the radio, though, Matt.
No threat of a technical foul. Here comes Delaware the other direction. Brown with it right wing. Kara, of course, known for her death stares towards the official during her playing days. Shire has it left wing for UD. Bad entry fee. Try to get it to Caracciolo. It's knocked away. Good hustle by Joy as she ties up Claire DeBoer. That preserves possession for UD. But sloppy all of a sudden offensively for Delaware. Caracciolo and Shire will check out. Nicholas and Jardine return for the Hens. But now questioning the arrow, but it is definitely Delaware's. The Hens won the tip, but now got the first tie-up, and now Delaware gets this one. Inbound comes far corner to Green. Green driving baseline. Help came, but she rose over it and somehow hits the floater. Tough finish. Hens by three. Here comes Bucknell racing into the forecourt. It's Courtney Green with 4 points early. Driving baseline inside Romaine. She's turned aside. Dishes off to Dotson. Dotson's pass taken away by Nicholas. Nicholas running into the forecourt, 1-on-3. Good decision to stop. Finds Leone, who hands it to the point guard, Brown. Brown sets up the offense, crossing over top of the circle to the right elbow. Fadeaway jumper, no. Long rebound corralled by Dotson for Bucknell. She'll hand it to the point guard, Greg. Greg bringing it into the forecourt. Dribbling foul line left, looking for an inside threat, trying to find DeBoer. Can't do it. Instead, around the perimeter, Jones, far side to Klotz. It's another triple. Her second of the game, and we're tied at 13 with 11:35 left of the first half.
And what a job right there by McKenna Nicholas on the defensive end to keep the ball out of DeBoer's hands. Bucknell was looking for her. She was trying to steal her, but Nicholas was not letting her.
And then a big foul call the other way, a moving pick against Steph Leone, her second. And that means problems for Delaware. Their best and biggest inside player picks up her second foul and will likely have to sit. It also takes us to a timeout on the floor. 11:30 left in the opening half. Delaware and Bucknell deadlocked at 13 on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
How much time?
First
11:30 left of the first half. Delaware and Bucknell tied at 13. And Bucknell with the basketball. Steph Leone picking up her second foul, has to sit down. Joy Caracciolo replacing her. Klotz fires up a quick jumper for Bucknell. Can't hit. Rebound Erica Brown. Going to bring it up herself all the way to the basket. Nobody stops ball. She misses the off-balance runner. And the board grabbed in traffic by Klotz for Bucknell. She brings it up herself. Weaves her way into the forecourt. Feeds off to DeBoer. Stripped by Nicholas. Ball loose on the floor. A tie-up. Nicholas tries to rip it free. Finally, the whistle comes. And the arrow will keep it with Bucknell. But Lauren, you noticed something offensively for the Hens. They're facing a Bucknell defense. It's switching on every screen.
It's switching on all the screens. So the guards need to look back, look into that screen roller, and look into that opposite man, opposite corner man that's going to be rolling up.
And they have some chances to go to the basket?
Absolutely. When that switch comes, that means that there's a post player lined up with the guard. So I would be looking to attack that basket.
Off the inbound, Nicholas ties up Claire Marie O'Brien. That's two straight jump balls forced by the hustle of Makeda Nicholas, and the true freshman gives the ball back to Delaware. Love to see the way that she is attacking the basketball and hitting the floor. Tied at 13. 9:15 into this game. Green with the ball for UD. Near corner feed to Caracciolo, being bumped the whole way. Finally got the whistle. Jackie Klotz picking up the foul. That is already the 15th foul on Bucknell.
Bucknell foul, 21, Jackie Klotz, her second team.
Second foul on Klotz as well, which is a problem for Bucknell. She has shot the ball well early. Had made only 1 3-pointer all season coming in and knocked down two in the early part of this contest. Jardine will throw it in. They have the arrow pointed the wrong way. Delaware just got the ball, the possession arrow. So nice heads up by the official to go over and get that change. So Delaware ball here. Jardine will throw it in near sideline, out near center court to Erica Brown. Bounce pass left wing to Green off a high screen from Nicholas, who did slip, but Green couldn't find her. She air balls a straightaway 16-footer. Missed the rim by 2 feet. Don't see that often from Green.
No.
Goes out of bounds back to Bucknell.
Not at all. It looked like she may have gotten bumped a little bit there, Matt, the way she came back off that. When she rose up, she came back down. She didn't come down the right way.
O'Brien with it, driving far baseline right around Jardine. Got in tight, could not hit the point-blank banker. And a rebound grabbed by Nicholas for UD. Outlets it forward to Brown, to Jardine, triple, got it, left wing, three is good, and the Hens are back on top, 16-13.
Hannah Jardine is finding her shot. She struggled early in this season, but she looks good, she looks confident going up with her shot now.
Near steal for Jardine, instead a blow by as Greg goes straight to the basket, and a reverse layup is good, but now back to within one. Hens have got to be careful, dribble penetration hurting them defensively a bit right now. Brown with it right wing, up top to Green. Left wing chest pass to Jardine, back to Green. Near corner, Brown for three, got it! What ball movement from UD! Erica Brown from deep, the Hens by four.
That was great ball movement, like you said, Matt. Courtney Green had the chance to put that shot up, but she saw the extra pass in the corner to Erica Brown.
Nice spin to get into the lane from McGirt. Left it to a big, but getting her shot blocked from behind was Dodson. It looked like Caracciolo and Nicholas got a piece. Here comes Delaware Brown all the way to the foul line. Got the left elbow jumper. Nobody stopped ball for Bucknell. Brown made the Bison pay. Timeout called by Bucknell head coach Aaron Roussel. He had to, as Delaware in transition, making some hay on the offensive end. Impressive stuff there. Brown doing a better job, it seems, Florida, of picking her spots, when to push it and when to start the offense, and the Delaware offense becoming the benefactor of that better decision.
Yeah, and that all goes back to her decision making. We saw in the beginning of the season where she was a little hesitant, and I think that had a lot to do with the decisions that she was making, the turnovers that she was causing, the bad shots that she was throwing up. But now it's almost like we're seeing a completely different player, and that player is only helping the Hens get better here.
Indeed, she's a big part of this recent run. Delaware trying to make it a third consecutive victory on the year. Now they are 3-3, both of the wins coming on the road. Vermont, a game they probably expected to have success in. Temple was a tough matchup, and Hens took it to the Owls. Now playing well against Bucknell, who has the ball, and they're called timeout. A collision away from the ball, and a foul caught against Audrey Dodson as she caromed in to Makeda Nicholas and Courtney Green. All three players hit the deck. And it's Dodson called for the foul, her first, and the 16th foul. So Delaware will shoot the rest of the half. I didn't see the collision. Was that, did Dodson?
It looked like Joy Caracciolo may have gotten away with one there and caused that.
That's what I thought I saw, but the official made the call so emphatically. Delaware with the basketball. The Hens will certainly take the break. Brown with it, top of the circle. Looking right wing for Green. Green near corner, Jardine. Lob entry to Caracciolo. Turn and face on the block. Powers up and banks it in and out. Offensive rebound tip, but then grabbed by Bucknell's DeBoer. DeBoer brings it forward. Leaves it right wing, Dodson. Around the perimeter, far side of the floor, McGurk. McGurk trying to drive baseline. She stepped on that baseline. Or did she push off? She pushed off, and that's even better. As she picks up the personal foul, it gives it back to UD.
And that was right there. That was all Makeda Nicholas right there. She stepped in. Erica Brown got beat there off the dribble. Makeda Lewis stepped in to help her out.
Rotation is becoming more solid for UD here in this last stretch. Hens on an 8-2 run have opened up a 21-15 lead. 8:20 to go in this opening half. It's Green up top to Nicholas. Nicholas, left-hand dribble to the elbow. Rise and fire. Can't hit. Left-rimmed it. Got a 15-footer off the mark. Board grabbed by DeBoer. Outlets it forward to McGurk. McGurk to the foul line. Leaves it off. A trailing three. Would not go for DeBoer. Back-rimmed it. High to grab the board. Green. Green wants to push. Racing into the forecourt. Fanning out to the right wing, crossing over to the top of the key, looking inside, instead right wing to Brown. Brown off a high screen, cross court feed, left wing Green, driving into the lane, bump, no call of contact. They'll say a clean strip, out of bounds. It'll stay with Delaware when we return. Time out of the four, 7:48 left to go in the first half. It's Delaware 21, Bucknell 15. This is Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV. We are
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Marvin King Davis.
There's talent there, though.
Welcome back, Carpenter Center. 7:48 to go in the opening half. Delaware 21, Bucknell 15. The defense from UD has been very solid early. And offensively, they've picked their spots when to run and made some good decisions. Jody Sire will throw it in baseline right. Lobbing the inbound to Erica Brown on the left wing. Brown putting it on the deck, dribbling towards the top of the key. Now splits a double team straight to the 10. Too high off the window, though, as it missed a bit strong. Rebound grabbed by DeBoer. Long outlet forward to Craig. Craig leaves it off to a teammate in tight. Marie O'Brien missed. Tried to throw it off the foot of Sawyer. It bounces into the hands of a teammate as Impaline's Irie ends up with it for Bucknell. Around the perimeter, she dishes it outside of McGurk, who will reset. 20 on the timer. Good hustle from Bucknell. And now a whistle and a foul away from the ball. Looked like it was a battle for position inside of Jody Sager. Going to be called for the personal. Her first. Team's sixth. Inbound will come baseline left. Delaware wasn't ready. And wide open underneath, Claire Marie O'Brien. Where was Makeda Nicholas there? That won't make Tina Martin happy. She was out along the perimeter and uncontested under the basket on the inbound. Here's Sawyer the other direction. Bad pass up top, take it away. Steal for Craig. She's going to go coast to coast and lay it home. And that quickly, it's a two-point game. Tina Martin is irate, takes the timeout, and is going to roll the dice here. Wants to put Steph Leone with two fouls back into the game. Her team up two with 6:55 to go in the first half. That's frustration, but also trust in her senior not to pick up foul number three.
Yeah, when you've seen the lead cut down to two now, and with Stephanie in the game, she was making things happen, especially on the defensive end. She was there. She was helping. But the biggest thing Stephanie does is on the defensive end with her communication. Her teammates hear her, and she's able to tell people where they need to go. So right now, putting Steph back in the game is a good decision.
Got to be careful, though. She's such a good screener, but she did get called for a moving pick, and that's the one bugaboo in her game. We will see her set some illegal screens. It's what gets her into foul trouble. Got to make sure you stress the message. Stay planted when setting those screens. A little bit of a tough start for Jody Sawyer. They sit her down, just try to calm her down a little bit.
Yeah, right now, I think both that decision that she made there with that pass was not only on her but on Erica Brown. She has to take her man down and seal her man, know that her man is overplaying her.
Green tries to attack off the bounce, gets in tight but can't finish. Rebound Bucknell. Here come the Bison. McGurk into the forecourt on the right wing. Feeds up top in Pauline's Irie. Back to McGurk. Top of the circle, chest pass to DeBoer. Around the perimeter, left wing to O'Brien. O'Brien driving towards the corner. Lobs it out top to Craig. Craig threw it towards the sideline. It was tipped out of bounds. Caracciolo got a fingertip on it. It'll stay with Bucknell. 11 to shoot, far sideline inbound. Comes in front of the Delaware bench. It goes to McGurk. She drives towards the basket, falls down, saves it inbounds, but Jardine's there to steal it. Outlets it for to Brown, racing into the forecourt. Finds a trailing Green, left wing triple, front rimmed it. Long rebound grabbed by Bucknell's tied to Craig. Here's Craig across the midcourt stripe. Left wing dish goes to McGurk. Up top, finds DeBoer. DeBoer dribbles to the foul line. Outside O'Brien. Right wing feed Craig, lobbing it inside. Wide open DeBoer, outside to O'Brien. Air balls a three from the left wing. Caracciolo grabs it. Gives it four to Brown. Brown on the secondary break, driving to the lane. Got her shot blocked from behind. Good rotation as Impaline's Irie sent it aside. It'll stay with Delaware. Shiera Jones returns for Bucknell, replacing McGurk. 21 on the timer here for UD. Brown to throw it in baseline right. Looking for some help. Lobs it to Jardine, foul line left. Jardine circling top of the key to the foul line. Now feeds it back outside to Brown on the left wing. Brown dribbling, top of the circle, bad entry feed. Impaline Zaire knocked it away, but Jardine got it. Thought the shot clock was winding down. Fired up a 25-footer that missed short. Rebound DeBoer. Stopped on dribble penetration by Brown. Finds a trailing Craig, who sets up the offense. Craig crossing over on Green. Driving left of the lane. Dishing near corner O'Brien. O'Brien being hand-checked the whole way. And finally the whistle comes, as Hannah Jardine will be called for the foul. That's her first, team seven, so a 1-1 coming here for Claire Marie O'Brien. Caracciolo checks out, and back in comes Nicholas. 5:13 left of the first half, Delaware 21, Bucknell 19. O'Brien is 77% foul shooter, hits the first, so she'll get a second. She now has 5 points, making all three of her free throws to this point. One more foul shot coming line left. She hits. A rare stoppage where we don't see a sub. We have seen a rotating door at the scores table. Both teams moving players in and out often. Here's Brown with it, forecourt for UD. Up top to Green. Elongated 6-0 run for Delaware. Left wing feed to Jardine. Lob entry feed to Leone. Tried an up and under. Couldn't get the defender in the air. Outside to Nicholas, who walked. Delayed call. But Nicholas moving a little too quick for her own good.
Yeah, in the last couple possessions we've seen for the Hens, it looks like there's a little bit of fatigue setting in here. We're getting close to halftime. Not great decisions. Like I said, we saw two turnovers at this point, so the Hens need to settle down because this is the point in that game where they make some bad decisions.
Jones near corner, dishes to DeBoer. DeBoer drives inside, got her shot rejected. Leone, another block for Delaware, who ends up with the ball. Flat-footed block shot for Steph Leone. Brown racing the other way, bumped on her way to the paint, and is fouled, and will head to the stripe for a 1-1. Erica Brown, good job to change pace and race it the other way, but how about the defense of Leone playing with two fouls, finding a way to block shots? She had two blocks in the last game and probably should have been credited for more than that. Seemed like she altered at least four more. Two free throws, or 1-1 rather, coming for Erica Brown. A slew of subs for Bucknell. As Craig goes out, DeBoer goes out, and Impaline Zaire checks out. Back in McGurk, Shiera Jones, and Audrey Dotson. Brown hits the first free throw, so she'll get one more. Bucknell, it's tough to keep track of the five players on the floor for Bucknell. It's like two or three in at each whistle. Second is good as well, 23-21. But nice job as Ruzel's trying to keep his team as fresh as possible. They go 12 deep in their regular rotation. With it far side of the floor, on the drive, it's Jones all the way to the basket. From the right wing to the left block, lays it home, and we're tied at 23. 4.25 minutes left in the first half. Delaware struggling a bit offensively here of late. Leone gets it on a bounce pass from Brown. Fakes a handoff to Green. Right wing feed to Jardine. Jardine back up top to Leone. Leone now will hand it off to Green. Green left hand bounce towards the elbow. Far corner feed to Brown. High arcing triple. Back rim no. Good rebound Leone. Lost it, but Green hustled it down. Fresh 30 here for UD, and they'll reset outside to Erica Brown. Good hustle by the Bluehead. Brown driving right wing, handing off Green. Lob entry to Clark, looks opposite to Leone. Hand off on the wing, Jardine. Jardine, hand off up top to Green. Green splits a double team straight to the basket. Lefty finish. I don't know how she finds a way to get through those small crevices, but she does.
Okay. And give her credit, she finds a way. She saw the shot clock going down, and she knew to attack the basket there.
And now Bucknell dribbles it off its foot as O'Brien loses it out of bounds. Good defense from Jardine, and the turnover gives it back to Delaware. Timeout on the floor, 3:21 left to go in the opening half. It's the Blue Hens 25, the Bison 23. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOB.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
I know what it takes to win a championship. The fire burns real. My teammates and I are motivated. And now it's our time. Experience it.
Delaware women's basketball brought to you by the Glasgow Medical Aid Units, making a difference one patient at a time over 60,000 times a year with locations in Glasgow, Christiana, and Middletown. Online at GlasgowMedicalCenter.com. Delaware leading Bucknell 25-23, 3:08 ticking left first half. Blue Hens with the basketball. Erica Brown with it, right wing, feeding up top Leone. It's an off target pass. It forced Leone to bounce it as she got it. She then put two hands on the ball, put it back on the deck, which is a double dribble, and Delaware turns it over.
And it was that Bucknell defense again causing that turnover. Stephanie Leone wanted to go to the corner to Erica Brown, but the Bucknell defender was right there.
Only the fifth turnover for the Hens. Bucknell's given it away 10 times already. They have the ball, though, outside with it. Dotson tried to thread the needle, a tough pass to Soon Swart, who lost it, got it back, and then is called for an offensive foul. Or they say that she double dribbled. She double dribbled, I beg your pardon. So it'll be Delaware ball on the 11th turnover of the game for the Bison. Brown walks it up for UD across the timeline, right wing. Hand off to Jardine, up top Leone. Leone dribbles left side. Takes the handoff to Green, now gives it to her on the wing. She fires a three, can't hit. Weak side rebound, O'Brien. Here's Claire Marie O'Brien dribbling the other direction. Hesitation move, dishing left wing McGirt. Driving to the foul line, picks up her bounce. Needs some help, lobs it right wing Jones. Fires up the three over Green and hits. Wow, that was a tough shot with Courtney Green giving her just a small sliver of space, but Bucknell up one.
Courtney Green's hand was right in her face. That was a very difficult shot.
Brown turns the corner all the way to the basket, hits it with a left hand, but then goes down awkwardly, colliding with O'Brien, slow to get up. She trails the play, but now racing the other way, trying to get advantage. Jones driving baseline. Good rotation by Delaware as Jardine tips away a pass, and Brown steals it. Here's Erica Brown dribbling to the foul line. Backdoor feed to Green, got bumped. They're going to call an offensive foul on Courtney Green. Boy, the officials, the way they're calling this game right now, there's a reason why there's no flow whatsoever, and I think it's the Zebras, to be blatantly honest.
Yeah, very up and down game as far as the officiating right now, and that's what, like you said, Matt, that's what's causing the unevenness here.
First foul on Green. She was being bumped most of the way to the basket. A lot of contact being allowed. Now Green pawing at Jones, knocked it away, but Jones got it back, elevates and hits just left of the lane. Short jumper, and it's 28-27, Bucknell back up by one. Jones averages just 4 points per game. Looks like a better offensive player than that.
Yeah, and both Jones and Colts, who's now on the bench in foul trouble, are both players right now that are putting up the points for Bucknell.
Green, foul line right on the bounce. Nice crossover move, got to the lane. Can't hit though, a little too strong off the window. And O'Brien grabbed the rebound. Outlets it forward to Jones, a minute left. Jones dropped the ball, fell down in front of us, but tipped it to a teammate, DeBoer, and now a timeout called by Bucknell. They did not have a use it or lose it timeout. That is a strange TO, as now both teams will take three to the second half with them. 28-27, Bucknell's lead. 55 and 2/10 seconds left. Why would you call a timeout there if you're Bucknell?
Well, especially on the offensive end right now, if you're looking to get points, Bucknell hasn't, outside that shot that Jones just hit, Bucknell hasn't really been scoring much right now. So if you want to go into the half on a scored basket, or at least on a very well-executed play where you get a good shot, I would say that was a good timeout.
On that point, how much of a carryover is there to the second half? I mean, there half ends momentum into the locker room. Can you bring it back out with you in the second half?
I think that you can, especially right now with the way that this game is being officiated, the stop-start kind of feel that we have to this game. Going in on a basket is only going to help you in the second half.
Bucknell gets the inbound to McGurk out of their called timeout. They better score, though. spinning towards the lane. O'Brien turned aside, dribbles out, right wing, fires up the triple, air ball short, and then on the box out, who's the foul on? Looked like Clark got fouled, and as a result, are they going to call the foul on Jade Clark? The officials unsure. One ref had it on Delaware, the other Bucknell. The official that had it on Bucknell wins the argument. And I think that's the accurate call. Jade Clark had position, got undercut. They call the foul on DeBoer. That's her first, team's eighth. So one and one here for Jade Clark. 42 seconds left of the half. Clark misses left rim with the free throw. She's 0 of 2 now for the stripe of the season. But now the rebound. O'Brien being bumped, and they call the foul. Crowd wanted a walk or a push-off. They won't get it. Instead, Courtney Green called for her second foul. And it is difficult to figure out what is a foul, what is not right now, as Nicholas and Brown will return for UD. Clark and Green exit for Delaware. Meanwhile, two more subs for Bucknell as Pauline Zyree comes back, as does Soon Swart.
Very up and down game, like you said, Matt, being called by the officials today.
O'Brien hits the first free throw, so she gets one more. Bucknell opening up a two-point lead. 34 and 6/10 seconds left in the first half. Second foul shot rattles home as well. So it's 30 to 27. The last minute of this opening half feels like it's lasted 10 minutes, and there's still a half a minute to go. Sager into the forecourt. Feeds top of the circle, Leone, and now a foul called on Delaware. An illegal screen called on Jody Sager. Wow, the call stacking up against UD. That'll give it back to Bucknell. Second foul on Sager. And Bucknell brings its offense back. Dotson returns, as does O'Brien. And DeBoer. It's McCurt that brings it across the timeline. Shot clock is off. Bucknell can hold for one. They lead by two. They should take an advantage into the locker room with them. Question is, what will that advantage be? McGurk winding clock down, dribbling out near center court. Now wants to attack with seven on the timer. Uses a high screen. Stopped by Sawyer. Good rotation. Leaves it outside. Dotson thought about a three. Fires it up. Sawyer blocked it. And Bucknell will not get a look as time expires. And the first half comes to a close. Helter skelter, to say the least. Also quite streaky. Heads led by as many as six. Bucknell held a two-point advantage. And that's the lead they take to the locker room. Weird first half, I think, is the best way to describe it.
Yeah, we saw that lead dwindle towards the end of the first half here. It looked like Delaware was getting a little tired. We talked about in the beginning of the season, we saw them making those bad decisions. When they start to get flustered, that's when those...
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place yours. To the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click submit.
Join today!
And welcome back to Beyond the Arc, joined now by the head coach of the women's basketball program, Tina Martin, whose team is 1-3. Coach, injuries are a part of the game of basketball, but your program has been bereft by them in the early going of the campaign. You lost Courtney Green to an MCL injury before the season even started. Joy Caracciolo just missed your last game, and certainly the injury that we all saw that Alicia Bell suffered against Marist. Let's start by updating the status of Alicia Bell. How's she doing?
She's doing okay. She went home. She had the surgery. They put a metal rod in her leg, and then they screwed it with screws in her knee and also in her ankle. And she will have that metal rod for the rest of her life. And so when we were joking with her, when she goes through airports, she's going to have to be real careful because she's going to go off a lot. But she's in good spirits. She's not going to come back until after Thanksgiving. She won't be able to put any pressure on the leg for a while, for months, at least 2 to 3 months, and then she'll start the rehab process. So right now, it's frustrating for her, and she misses the team. She was resting comfortably when I talked to her on the phone, and she's very excited about coming back after Thanksgiving.
When you have an injury that serious, it's really about more than basketball, but that does affect your team on the floor. And certainly Caracciolo and Green were supposed to be a big part of what you guys were going to be offensively this season. How have you adjusted to all the missing bodies?
Well, not as well as we'd like. I mean, we're 1-3, so the bottom line is that Courtney was out for those 3 weeks with the MCL, and that threw off her timing for the first, I think, 2 games, and then she really has now recovered and playing much better. Joy is out right now with a concussion that was sustained outside of basketball, so, I don't know when she'll be back. I'm hoping that we get her back for the game up in Vermont, but I'm not 100% sure. We won't know anything till after Thanksgiving, but yeah, it definitely has thrown a wrench into what we're trying to do. The consistency of the team play has been very inconsistent. We don't have the senior leadership. Steph is trying to provide it, but she's only one person. And so right now, it's a struggle for our youngsters. And we're playing a lot of freshmen and sophomores, and they're going to have to get it. You go into a season not expecting to have 3 big injuries right away to 3 of your main players. And when that happens, you're going to be inconsistent, and hence we've lost some games and have not played as well as I think we're capable of playing.
Some of the inconsistencies and the youth have come at that point guard position. In your win over Marist, Jody Sawyer and Erica Brown combined for 8 assists, 2 turnovers. But in the 3 losses, only 7 assists and 25 giveaways. How do you get them going?
Well, I mean, they have to stay within themselves. I think, Erica's more of a scoring point guard. She's taken a lot of what I call runners instead of taking the pull-up. She's been inconsistent with that. She needs to take more pull-up jump shots and be a little bit more stable. And then when she gets in the paint, she's trying to make some great looks, some great passes instead of just making the easy pass. And the Jody situation is she's not looking to score enough. I think she's turning the ball over because she's trying to force it in when she should take the shot. And so, they just have to have more composure. They are only sophomores. They've only played, of the 30 games we played last year and now they've played 33 games in their careers. So they are still very young. They're trying to do too much. They're trying to make up for the teammates that have been out. And I just need them to relax and play smarter. They're making bad decisions right now, and they'll learn. They'll learn. They're great kids. They're hard workers. Eventually, it'll come around. But right now, they're just pressing too much.
With the challenging non-conference schedule that you have this season, the 1-3 record is not what you would want it to be. But you look to the positives, and the game against East Carolina kind of got away from you guys. It was a rout, but played much better in the contest against Fordham. Held them to 49 points. You played pretty solid defensively.
Yeah, these teams we've played early on, Lafayette actually is playing really well. They haven't lost to my knowledge of yet. And they've played really well, and they've got a bunch of seniors and juniors. But, and then you go on to the other teams, and they're all NCAA or NIT teams. Fordham won the A-10, Marist won the MAC, and then East Carolina won 24 games last year and went to the NIT. So, and they've got everybody back, plus a junior college All-American. So, we've played good competition. We did rally and played better defense against Fordham. It was a low-scoring game. I thought our kids tried to grind out a win. We came up a little short, got some good looks at the end, couldn't make it, but we got good looks. So that's all anybody can ask for right now. When you've got a sophomore and freshman in there, you know, you just hope they can step up and come through. But it's a good learning experience for these kids, and we will get better.
Let's talk about those freshmen. Makeda Nicholas has been consistently in the lineup and has really given you guys some good minutes inside. And then Chastity Taylor, in her collegiate debut, scores 12 points after not playing in the opener. It's going to be up and down. That's what freshmen do. But they've given you some good minutes in the early go.
They really have, you know. And I think Makeda, again, she is going too fast when she gets the ball. I think she can help us in the scoring department. Right now, she gets it, and the first thing she wants to do is dribble. You know, she's nervous, and she wants to do well. But she's been on the board. She had 7 or 8 rebounds in her last game against a pretty big front line for Fordham. And I think she has a very bright future for us. And Chastity has probably been a little more inconsistent in that she played really well in her first opportunity. And then yesterday got in foul trouble, was out of position a couple times, didn't rotate. So we had to take her out and talk to her again about where she needed to be on the floor. Again, it's a learning prospect right now for her. She's got to get what to do on the defensive end. I know she can score the ball, but she needs to play defense to help us.
We'll take a break here on Beyond the Arc. When we come back, we'll look forward to Delaware's next game coming up on the road at Vermont. As we continue with Delaware head coach Tina Martin.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
I know what it takes to win a championship. The fire burns real. My teammates and I are motivated. And now it's our time. Experience it.
Welcome back to Beyond the Arc. I'm Matt Janis with Delaware Women's Head Coach Tina Martin. Coach, it's the Thanksgiving season. I guess we should open up this segment by asking you, what are you thankful for?
Oh, well, I'm thankful to be the coach at the University of Delaware, that's for sure. I've been here for 19 years, and I can't express how much Delaware has been my home now. And I love it here. I love this university, and I'm very thankful that I have the head coaching position here. I'm thankful for my family, certainly, wonderful people, and come to my games and support me, and friends, of course, I'm thankful for them as well. And I couldn't be more blessed, to be honest with you, and of course my team. You know, every year I have a new team, and I get to mold them and try to shape them and try to motivate them and inspire them, and so I can't complain. I mean, I am so grateful for all the things in my life, and very happy. Even though we're 1-3, you know, I like to win. I'm not gonna. Everybody knows that. Everybody that knows our program, but I am thankful I'm in this position, and every single day I give it everything I have to produce the best team we could possibly put on the floor.
Well, that's a great perspective to have, particularly this time of year as your 1-3 team looks to get better. You have kind of an awkward schedule because you have a road trip surrounding the holiday. How do you deal with that with a team when you have Thanksgiving on a Thursday and then you depart for a long trip to Vermont on a Friday?
Yeah, you know, I want the kids to spend time with their families. I think the holidays are extremely important, and so we have Thanksgiving Day off, and most of our players live within that 3 to 4 hour radius, so they'll be going home to their families and having Thanksgiving, and then we're all going to meet up at BWI. We're flying out of there, actually, on Friday morning, fly up to Vermont. We'll practice at Vermont in late afternoon, and then get ready for the game on Saturday afternoon. So we had a practice this morning, and so the kids went hard for 2 hours, and then everybody safely, hopefully, got home, and we'll enjoy their family, and then we'll get ready. So, you know, I like the holidays to be spent with family, though. I really do. And if it's at all possible, we try to make that happen.
What, looking forward to this Vermont team, do you see from the Catamounts? What are some of the challenges they present?
Well, they go 4 out, 1 in. They've got some very good three-point shooters. They got a fifth-year graduate student, Katier, I hope I pronounced her name right, but she is a 6'2", 6'3 post player who has a fifth-year senior transferred into Vermont, and she's good with her left or her right hand. They've lost some tight games. They've lost a couple games by 2 points, by 4 points. We got to get out to the shooters, and we're going to have to defend inside. We're going to have to dig on the post player and then really defend the three-point shot.
You guys have gone on the road twice, still looking for the first win with a young team. That can always be a really challenging team. a really challenging thing. What do you think you've learned as a group about going on the road early?
Well, I mean, you know, going on the road is really different. I always like to tell my team that you're 10 down when you go on the road. You have to come out with that fighting spirit, with that chip on your shoulder. I don't think that this young team has gotten quite that yet. They're trying to get it, but I would like us to be able to establish tempo right away. We haven't been able to do that in either one of the two away games, and so we're going to be able to hopefully get on the floor and really get the ball inside, you know, to both Hannah Jardine. If Joy's available, certainly we'd like to get the ball and establish a post game with Joy, if she is available. And then, you know, I want our guards to be able to get to the rim. I think we've settled for a lot of jump shots early on, and we need to be able to knock down not only the three ball, but also the pull-up jumper. And I'd like Erica Brown to take that pull-up jumper a little bit more. So we need to establish a tempo offensively to help ourselves when we're on the road. And we haven't done that in the first two away games.
And then looking down the line, the challenging schedule continues. On Wednesday, you go to Temple game in Philadelphia. Yeah. Temple, a team a little similar to yourselves. They've challenged themselves in non-conference play. A little bit of a slow start, but really tough competition, and they're a tough team.
Yeah, they are. They're a physical team. They play man-to-man, get in your face, hang all over you. We had a tough game with them here at the Bob Carpenter Center last year. Came down to the last few minutes. I'm expecting another tough game. It'll be at Temple. So, you know, Tanya always has her teams ready, and they are very athletic, of course, and they're bigger. They've got two kids inside, 6'2", 6'3". This is a challenging schedule for our team. It really is. We're not playing any, as they would say, you know, bad teams. We're playing NCAA teams, NIT teams, physical teams, and we're going on the road, you know, to do it. So this is a young group that is definitely being pushed to the limit right now, especially with the injuries we've had. And so we have to battle back. We got to crawl out of this hole that we're in right now, and hopefully we will respond. You know, the future is really bright here, but right now, you know, our backs are against the wall, and we need to come out fighting.
Last question, what are the long-term upsides, though, to challenging your team the way you have? I mean, what do you hope to gain out of this type of schedule?
Toughness. You know, I think right now we've been very inconsistent in that category. You know, we've shown it at times, but in order to be a competitive Division I team, you have to have toughness. You have to get stops when you're supposed to get stops. You have to execute and get the looks and then find your go-to person to knock down those shots. We've got several options for that. We've got, obviously, Courtney Green, and we've also got, you know, Erica Brown, two kids that are underclassmen, but they shoot the ball well and they can get to the rim. And then inside, I would hope that I could count on my senior Joy, who would be able to get an offensive rebound.
For the field, 37%, 3 of 8 from three, 38%. And the Hens out-rebounded by 6, 21-15, which was, you said, a big key coming in.
Yeah, and especially here in the second half, we talked about how Bucknell is also a strong team in this beginning of the second half. So Delaware right now needs to work on, they need to focus on weathering the storm right now.
Bucknell ball to start the second half, and the officials pick up right where they leave off. The hand check call, this one on Erica Brown, her first, team's first. And the first whistle comes 7 seconds into the second half. Seemed like very little contact. And it seemed like they let him play for the first 10 to 12 minutes, and then all of a sudden he couldn't breathe on anybody. Bucknell with the ball on the inbound. Outside McGirt. McGirt feeding inside to Dotson. Back out to McGirt. Right wing to O'Brien. O'Brien driving to the elbow, and she walked. Lost her footing. Good defense. Hannah Jardine moving her feet that time. Did a pretty good job. So Delaware gets it back offensively for the first time. On the floor to start the second half for UD. Brown at the point, Green the two, Hannah Jardine the three, Makeda Nicholas the power forward, and Steph Leone the center. It's the starting five. Starting five also out there for Bucknell as Green drives far quarter. Dishes outside of Leone. Hand off to Brown, top of the circle. She drives right of the lane, into the basket, and floats it home with a finger roll. And ends back to within one at 30-29. Here comes Bucknell looking to run. Delaware back defensively. Up top with it. Top of the circle to Boer. To Boer. Left wing McGirt. Over to the right side, Dotson. Dotson near corner to Craig. Driving baseline. Jardine there with the help. And altered the shot. But the rebound grabbed by Bucknell. And then a foul called against Erica Brown, who didn't have a single foul in the first half. Well, she's got two now. And 1 minute in the second half. Team second as well. It's 30-29 Bucknell ball. They lead by one. The inbound comes baseline left. McGirt gets it in. Near corner, Dotson driving into the lane, and another foul. This one, I believe, will go on Nikita Nicholas, who came over and helped, got a piece of the arm. Clock never started either, so they'll have to run some time. I believe they'll have to put 18:55 on the clock. It says 19 minutes right now. Dana Martin yelling to her team, we need strong help side right now. We don't need that nonsense. Better rotation?
Better rotation. And what Coach Ruiz talked about in the halftime interview, she said that they were going to start going over the top and hard hedging. We saw there that Courtney Green and Makeda Lewis got a little tripped up, and that might have been what caused that foul in the lane there.
Trying to come over and figure out how much time's left on the clock. I think it should be 18:55. But that's just my opinion. Nobody asked me. Tina Martin calls her team over. Bucknell has its team over at the bench as well. Kind of a gift time out here for both clubs. And this is not going to help improve the rhythm of the contest, is it? I mean, when you have a break in the action, 3 fouls in a minute, plus this is at least 90-second pause in action and still ticking here. Now they're going to go over the monitor to check it. All this for 5 seconds. Tina Martin and Janine Radice up talking to their team defensively. When you are in help side on that back line, is that Nicholas who needs to come over another extra step there, or who is just a half step late getting over?
It looked like from here, it looked like Makeda Nicholas. She should have been in there and stationary. Instead, she was late, and that's what forced her to come in and try and swat that ball out from behind.
We're at the Value Days broadcast table presented by Exxon and Shell. It's Bucknell 30 and Delaware 29. It's Value Days of participating Shell, Exxon, and Dashens throughout Delaware. Every Monday, save 10 cents per gallon off diesel, save 20 cents per gallon off premium gas on Tuesday, and save 5 cents off per gallon on all grades of gasoline each Thursday. Still no determination on the time right now. Dotson will be at the line to shoot a pair when we do finally figure out what the clock should read. Dotson is an excellent foul shooter, 84% from the line on the season. 19 minutes showing on the clock at the moment. Delaware Women's Basketball wants to remind you that Slam Dunk to the Beach is back. The nation's premier high school basketball showcase returns to Lewis, Delaware, December 27th, 28th, and 29th at Cape Henlopen High School. The same tournament that brought you LeBron James, Carmelo Anthony, and Kevin Durant will now feature the future of college and NBA hoops before their stars. Tickets for single game and three-day passes are available right now. Visit them online at slamdunktothebeach.com. You're not from the state of Delaware, but you hear Slam Dunk to the Beach growing up in central Pennsylvania?
I did it.
Never
did
heard
not.
Of it. It was the best high school basketball tournament for boys basketball in the country. What's the biggest showcase event you ever played in back in your high school days?
The Linnet Tournament.
Where is that?
Scranton, Pennsylvania.
Local. Is that where Tina Martin found you?
Her brother.
You take any advantage you can. This is absolutely ridiculous, by the way. 19 minutes left in the second half. Bucknell 30, Delaware 29. And we still have not restarted action. I'm not sure whether the clock is down at the moment or what's going on. Fans beginning to get a little testy. It's been a long day of basketball. Men's game earlier did not go the way Delaware was hoping, or at least some parts of Delaware, Delaware State. Those fans were happy. 66-53, they beat UD. And now the team's going to go back over to their respective benches as all three officials in a conversation. What could the conversation possibly be? Pick a point on the clock and just put that much time on the clock rather than sit here. I can't figure out what could possibly take this long.
I think you should go help them and fix it.
In two more minutes, I might get up and go talk to them. I don't understand. Unless there's some kind of a malfunction on the clock, this can't take this long. It shouldn't. And the crowd is, you hear some catcalls in the background, starting to get a little frustrated. I don't think I've seen a delay this long without any kind of a clock malfunction. And now they go back over to the other side of the scorer's table. I don't know. We'll tell you, though, that Delaware Women's Basketball, presented by our friends at Concord Pet Food and Supplies. For everything your pet needs, visit ConcordPetFoods.com or any of their 27 locations in the area. Bucknell will shoot free throws, theoretically, at some point. They lead Delaware 30-29. Right now it says 19 minutes on the game clock. Evidently, I was wrong. Evidently, it was more than 5 seconds because they're putting 18:44.
Game clock adjusted, 18 minutes, 44 seconds.
Well, I guess they finally got it. That was longer than the Lincoln-Douglas debates, but 18:44 is what they decide. Two free throws coming here for Autry Dodson. Both teams should almost get warm-ups again. That delay was so low.
They might as well at this point.
Dodson's first free throw is good, 31-29. Although not the worst timing for Delaware. They were having a little bit of a rotation miscue. It allowed them to go back over what they want.
Yeah, you saw Tina Martin over there with the chart out. She was over there talking to her team, hopefully about that defensive rotation, that breakdown that we just saw at the opposite end.
Both free throws good, so the lead is 3-4 Bucknell. The clock operating and running correctly. Green with it, far side of the floor, dribbling to the foul line, lobbing left wing to Brown. Brown, jab step, right hand bounce towards the elbow, now crosses over left side, but scoops it too hard off the window. And a rebound grab by DeBoer for Bucknell. Outlets it forward to McGurk. McGurk lobs it for Craig, who misses point blank and then goes over the back of Delaware. And a foul called on Bucknell. It's Tyler Craig on the personal.
Tyler Craig, her third,
and the team's first. So Craig a starter. And one of the point guards for this Bucknell team has to sit down. Jackie Klotz, who missed a lot of the first half with foul trouble in her own right, comes in for the Bison. Delaware will walk it up just under 2 minutes into this second half. Bucknell 32, Delaware 29. Brown with it in the forecourt for UD. Left wing on the dribble. Tried to hand it off to Green. Lost it, but Green able to chase it down. Green getting played off of, so she'll fire and hit for three. Not sure why Klotz was not respecting the shot, but Green made her pay. Klotz tries to answer the other way, driving baseline, and scoops it home. Over Hannah Jardine. Nice finish.
Klotz, for the moments of these games that she's been in today without being in foul trouble, she's really keeping Bucknell in the game.
How about Janine Rodiz saying staff scouted her in the summertime? Hadn't seen much from her this year, but they know she's a good shooter. Green with it, top of the circle, right wing feed over to Brown. 17:30 left, second half, 34-32. Bucknell on top by a deuce. Delaware with the ball. Brown, hesitation move, push off, no call. Elevates from the left elbow, misses the shot. Followed her own miss, got it back, lost it, out of bounds to Bucknell. Good hustle by Erica Brown, but she just couldn't quite corral it. A little frustration there. She slams the ball down. Brown going to go out, as will Makeda Nicholas. Caracciolo returns. Jody Sager in. Meanwhile, for Bucknell, Sierra Jones comes into the contest, and O'Brien will take a seat. Bucknell ball up by two. There's not much energy in the building. Helter-skelter game, a long delay already in the second half, a weird feel. Here's a slip inside, trying to get it. Dodson near the basket, but a poor pass from Jones. Dodson was open, but Jones threw it too low. It goes out of bounds back to UD. That was a nice slip. That was what you were talking in the first half that Delaware has an opportunity to do.
Exactly, and that right here, we just saw it. Stephanie Leone, instead of going in, though, she stepped out. Not exactly Stephanie's range, though.
But gave the opportunity for Caracciolo to seal the block, and she lays it home with the right hand. And we're tied at 34. 16 and three-quarter minutes remaining in the second half. It's Jones being pawed at. Lost handle, but got it back. DeBoer gets a hand off right wing. Gives it off to McGurk. McGurk at the foul line. Her pass tipped by Green, but a bad bounce for Delaware. It goes to DeBoer, and then DeBoer is fouled. Steph Leone picking up the personal. That's her third. Team's fourth already in 3 minutes and 26 seconds of this second half. So fouls mounting up on Delaware. Inbound will come baseline left from McGurk. Looking and finds a teammate right wing. It's DeBoer driving into the lane. Can't finish in tight. Jardine altered the shot. Long rebound grab by Green. Looking to run. Two on one with Caracciolo. Nice feed and Joy lays it home. Pins back up by two. Green dribbled until she finally drew the defense and then slipped it to Caracciolo. Here's an answer and a deep two from the right side. Good for Klotz. You can't go under the screen against Jackie Klotz, who's having a good shooting night. Tied again at 36. 16 minutes to go in the second half. Jardine, right wing. picks up her bounce, feeds high post Caracciolo, backing down on the defender. Her shot was blocked. Pretty good defense by DeBoer. She set it to the baseline. That'll take us to a timeout on the floor. 15:53 left in the second half. We are tied at 36. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Hey fans, 12 and younger. Do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
I know what it takes to win a championship. The fire burns real. My teammates and I are motivated. And now it's our time. Experience it.
Still sort of seem like they're feeling each other out, don't they? They know what they want to do, but both defenses are playing just well enough that it's kind of taking them out of their initial look, and they're having to rely heavily upon plan B and plan C.
Yeah, and it's very difficult, like we talked about, having to get back into your offensive rhythm with the stops and starts that we've seen in this game so far.
Courtney Green will throw it in, baseline left for UD in this tie contest. They get it into Leon far corner, hand it off to Green. Green driving to the elbow, back to Leon in the corner. Two dribbles, gives it to Green, got away with an offensive foul as she set a clear moving screen. Instead, a left wing dish, Jardine hits the three. Hannah Jardine off the feed from Green, and it ends by three.
Courtney Green, assist.
Bucknell the other way. Clots outside, lobbing inside, and it's stolen away. Joy Caracciolo swooped in to take the ball. Gives it to Jody Sawyer, and she'll slow things up and run a play on the left wing, dribbling to the foul line. Cross-court feed, Jardine for three. That one wouldn't go. Offensive board, Caracciolo gets drilled. It comes down awkwardly on her right knee. Oh, Joy Caracciolo hyper-extended her right knee. She is down on the baseline and just have to hope that it was an awkward landing and she's all right. But she's down. Kelly Stafford, the Delaware trainer, over to tend to her. And again, it gets quiet here inside the Carpenter Center. Already have seen one major injury this year, Alicia Bell going down. And now Caracciolo down along the baseline. And they are immediately looking at that knee. And it grows very quiet here at the bottom. Caracciolo at her senior season at Delaware, the transfer from Boston College, who had really started to come on after suffering a concussion a couple of weeks ago, was able to get back in the lineup and had been playing well. She is down right now. They help her to sit up. And the only thing you can hope is it was just a twist and she got scared more than anything. You never know. Can't put any pressure, it seems, on that right knee. They're helping her off the floor. How about that? Tina Martin draped the arm around her neck and with the training staff helping her over. You don't see the head coach get involved in that all that often. And now they hand her off to one of the assistants who will walk Caracciolo back towards the locker room. So you just hope that Joy Caracciolo is okay. Both for her, because good kid that you don't want to see any injuries, and then also for this Delaware team that lacks depth on the front line. So we'll restart action. The inbound goes to Leon far corner. Hens up three with the ball. 15:08 to go in the second half. Crowd still kind of quiet watching Caracciolo limp off behind the seats. And Sawyer walked up top. Dragged the pivot foot as she picked up her bounce and was looking for a teammate. And a turnover gives it back to Bucknell. And we have seen, unfortunately, a little bit of everything in this game today. It seems like every time the game starts to find a little rhythm, something goes awry. McCurk with it left wing. Great feed inside, but missing from tight to the basket. DeBoer rebound tipped out of bounds by Bucknell. DeBoer tried to get back her own miss, but lost it out of bounds. That's a bunny you got to convert on if you're the 6'1 sophomore out of Michigan. Delaware ball up three. Can they create a little space between themselves and Bucknell? Green with it, right wing for UD. Driving baseline, being bumped the whole way, and they call the foul. This one on Chiara Jones. Third team foul. Already in this second half, the teams combining for 7 fouls in less than 5.5 minutes. Subbing in for Bucknell, Autry Dotson.
Foul number 34, Chiara Jones, her second, team's third.
Out of contest will go Claire DeBoer. Inbound will come for the Hens, baseline left. It's Sawyer looking to trigger. Gets it in, far corner Green. Green surveying her options, puts it on the deck, dribbling out on the wing. Spinning, backing up, firing a three, it's blocked. Good block by Impaline Zairee. And here comes Bucknell. She has long arms and used the wingspan to her advantage. Green thought she had freed herself up. Picking up the bounce on the right wing, McGurk. Up top, Impaline Zairee. Cross-court feed, left wing, goes over to Dotson. Dotson feeds to Klotz outside. Green gives her space, and Klotz makes her pay. Can't step off Jackie Klotz. She hits another triple, and we're tied at 39.
Very, very quick release by Jackie Klotz. You cannot give her any space at all. The Hens at this point might just want her to put the ball on the floor and wait for that help defense to come.
Well, Janine Radice was not happy. We heard the scouting report at halftime. Irate, they would give her some space inside for Leon. She is bumped. The long arms of Impaline Zairee. It's the fourth team foul on Bucknell. Second on Impaline Zairee. Sire's going to check out. Brown will return for UD. So the 5-4 for Delaware. Brown and Green in the backcourt. Jardine the three. Nicholas is the power forward and Leon the center. Inside of the right block it goes to Nicholas. She leaves her feet without knowing what to do with it. Just fires it off the backboard. Here comes Bucknell the other direction. Jones gets a long outlet. Forces a left elbow jumper and hits. And Bucknell up to 41-39. Not a pretty shot, but effective over the long arms of Leon. So every time it looks like Delaware will have a little control in this game, Bucknell takes it back. Now can the Hens respond? Green curling off a screen, straight to the basket, hit the bottom of the backboard. Leon got the rebound. Outside to Jardine, driving left of the lane and banks it home. Nice shot in traffic, and we're tied at 41. Here's McGurk into the forecourt. Left wing feed Dotson, up top in Pauline Zairee. Right wing feed over to Klotz. Around the perimeter, right side McGurk. Up top Jones. Jones got some space, fires the triple and hits. 44-41. They have to get up on the shooters. Jones and Klotz, you can't give them space.
Jones and Klotz, not two players that were averaging more than 4 points between the two of them coming into these games, and they have 13 and 15 by themselves right now.
And Tina Martin's going to take a timeout. We will take it with the Delaware head coach. 12:32 to go in the second half. Bucknell 44 and the Blue Hens 41. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. I'm gonna make this place yours.
To go in the second half. Bucknell 41. Bucknell 44. Delaware 41. The Blue Hens having to use some different lineups out there right now. Joy Caracciolo left with a knee injury a little bit ago. The good news is saw her put some weight on that knee. She was trying to walk it off behind the stands. So hopefully she's all right long term. But as a result, she's out of the game now. Brown with it far corner for Delaware. 9 on the timer as she dribbles him. front of her own bench. Feeds up top to Green. Left hand bounce towards the foul line. Baseline left to Taylor. Got the defender in the air, then fired the jumper, but it wouldn't go. She hit off the front rim. Rebound grab by Bucknell. Here come the Bison the other direction. McGurk lost the handle, got it back. Feeds left wing to Dotson. Dotson up top. Impaline's Irie, a foul away from the ball, called on Bucknell. Offensive foul, battling for position inside. McGurk put her backside into Brown, but it was Klotz called for the foul, which is good news for Delaware, because she's been killing the Hens, and that's her third. You'd like to see Jackie Klotz getting a little foul trouble if you're UD. Taylor with it, right wing for Delaware, up top Jardine. 11:52 to go, second half, Hens down three to Green, top of the circle. Right wing chest pass, Jardine fires up a long jumper. Back rim, no. Rebound, McGurk. Here she comes, weaving left, then right, back left. Lost handle, spins out near the left wing. Feeds top of the circle, Impaline's Irie. Back to McGurk. Up top to Jones, wide open triple straight away. This one wouldn't go. Hens dodge a bullet there as Leon pulls down the board.
The Hens are giving these shooters from Bucknell way too much room right now.
Brown all the way to the paint. Could have kept going to the basket. Instead, dishes outside to Green. Green, foul line right, surveys her option. Jardine sets a screen for her. Backs up, wide open triple right wing. Back rim, no. Jardine, good offensive rebound. Got fouled on the floor. And it'll be Delaware ball when we come back. Already the 16th foul on the Bison. So Delaware will shoot on every foul the rest of this game. 11:10 to go, second half. Bucknell 44, Delaware 41. This is Blue Hens women's basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
We are the champions. Throw your hands up, welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
A little melodramatic. to go in the second half. Bucknell 44, Delaware 41. In a game where both teams have struggled to find footing and any kind of offensive consistency, Delaware has gotten Bucknell to 16 fouls, which means the Hens can live at the line, which could really help Delaware's effort in the second half.
It could, and especially right now with not a lot of these outside shots falling, the Hens can attack the rim, not just finish, but get to the line and shoot free throws. You have 11 minutes left and already in the 1-1.
Hens made four of their first 8 3-point shots. They've missed five of their last six, though. Jardine inside to Leon, back outside to Hannah in the far quarter. Up top Green, straightaway triple. That one's good. Rattles home, and the Hens have tied it up with 10 3/4 minutes left to go. Here's Bucknell the other way. Great lob pass inside. Dotson finishes on the feed from Impaline's Irie. What a pass. She sealed the backside defender, had to thread the needle over Leon, and did it with precision. Green, right wing, thought about a three. Now dribbling towards the top, 15 on the timer. Hens down by two with the ball. Right wing to Leon. Back to Green. Foul line right. 4-3. That one wouldn't go. Front rimmed it, but then stole the ball away on the rebound try. Dives to the floor after it, and a tie-up will keep it with Delaware. A pure effort play from Courtney Green.
What a way. Courtney Green missed that shot, still went after the rebound, hustling all over the floor to keep the Hens in the game right now.
Some good news. Joy Caracciolo is standing on her own power back behind the seats over near where Delaware's old locker room used to be. So hopefully that means Caracciolo's okay, but then bad news on the inbound. Delaware drops the ball out of bounds and off the chest of Erica Brown into the sideline. And a turnover gives it to Bucknell. Hens down two. We are halfway through this second stanza. Delaware trying to extend a season-high winning streak to three games and get above 500 for the first time this year. Mismatch inside, Brown on clots. They can't take advantage. Craig drives inside. Brown tries to help late and gives the foul. And Erica Brown, who had no fouls in the first half, now has three. And a fifth team foul, two foul shots coming for Tyler Craig.
Yeah, and Erica Brown coming in a little bit late there on that help side defense, but understandable, she's got a big assignment, a defense assignment right now covering Klotz.
Seems like they made that switch and told Brown, don't let Klotz have any space. As Craig hits the first free throw, interesting change that then they move Klotz inside and try to post up the smaller Brown.
Yeah, now we're looking at six foot Jackie Klotz on 5'7" Erica Brown. So the help defense is definitely going to have to come now.
Second free throw good as well. 48-44. Bucknell opening up a four-point lead. 9:50 to go, second half. Delaware with a basketball. Brown dribbling out between the rings. Crossing over right side. Now changes direction back left. Tried to slip it to Nicholas, but she did not go to the basket. It heads out of bounds instead. And Tina Martin takes a timeout. She's not pleased with her team. Remember that timeout that Delaware had to use when nobody was around for the inbound in the first half? That could come back to be big because Delaware has just one timeout remaining with still 9:44 to go in this game.
Yeah, we've seen that a lot this season with the inbounds plays, the five-second calls that have been called. Today they had a wasted timeout. That's something that Delaware needs to look at for games to come and something that they need to improve on.
And the one mistake today was a flat-out lack of concentration. Nobody was down there with Sawyer, but you're right, there have been other plays where they try to get into their center just off by a hair. You know, it has to be precise for those to work.
Yeah, and that's just execution on the Hens' part, paying attention and being able to execute what the coaches are asking you to do.
9:44, second half. Bucknell ball out of Delaware's called timeout. Bison will throw it in under their own basket. They get it in to Craig. And a walk. Craig gave it to Impaline Zaire, who wasn't expecting it, and a clear move of the feet. Well, that is an unforced error there from the Bison. Delaware came out with a little token pressure, but shouldn't have been enough to force a giveaway. Brown will throw it in now. Baseline left to Jardine. Foul line right. Jardine inside of Leon on the block, backing down the defender. Hook shot, would not go, couldn't get the roll. Nicholas tipped the rebound, but Klotz ends up with it. Outlets it forward to Craig. Craig pushing the other direction, moving right towards the wing. Feeds to Klotz, Brown all over her. Cross-court dish, stumbling O'Brien, but somehow kept her footing. Feeds it outside, driving towards the lane, DeBoer. Cross-court feed, Klotz, three, bounces twice off the rim and falls. 50-44, as they say, a deep two, but it's a six-point Bison lead. Largest of the game for Bucknell in terms of advantage. 17 for Jackie Klotz. On the drive, Nicholas forces an off-balance runner that wouldn't go. Rebound grabbed by Bucknell. Here come the Bison the other direction. Left wing O'Brien up top, Impaline Zaire feeding near corner, open DeBoer, doesn't take the shot, instead Impaline Zaire misses it badly from the foul line, airballed it, rebound Delaware, Brown going the other way, on the run, into the lane, offensive foul. And Erica Brown just picked up her fourth. The defender was moving, but Brown looked like she extended her arm. That one could have went either way.
And we've seen the last couple offensive possessions for the Hens. They look very, very out of sorts right now. Very out of sorts. And this is where we come back to Jody Salyer and Erica Brown slowing the game down, directing the team, realizing that you haven't scored in a couple possessions and you need a basket.
Tina Martin and Janine Radice trying some different combinations. Alexis Sears comes in and gives up a three, but it would not go. Back rim, long rebound, tipped by Bucknell, out of bounds. It'll go back to Delaware. Sears was a little late rotating over on Claire O'Brien on the help side. Got caught too tight to the basket, but O'Brien couldn't make her pay. It looked like Hens maybe went a little zone there, at least the way they were rotating. Have not played much zone this year. Sire with it top of the circle. Dribbling towards the Delaware bench, far side of the floor. Picks up her bounce, feeds outside to Green. It was a wide pass. Green grabs it just before it went into the backcourt. Now dribbling towards the left wing. Crossover move towards the baseline. Stumbles and spins back to the perimeter. Eight on the timer. Green driving baseline. Double comes. Tried to look opposite. It's stolen away. Was looking for Jardine, but O'Brien rotated over and stole it. Now Klotz open left wing. Doesn't pull the trigger. Instead, cross court feed right wing to O'Brien. She'll feed up top. Green tipped it, but Craig got it. 7:40 to go. Bucknell by six with the ball. And a foul called on Delaware, which is going to send Bucknell to the stripe for a 1-1. When we return, timeout on the floor, and it's Delaware trailing Bucknell 50-44 with 7:40 left in the second half. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOB.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
I know what it takes to win a championship. The fire burns real. My teammates and I are motivated. And now it's our time. Experience it.
.740 to go, second half. Bucknell 50, Delaware 44. It has been a real struggle for the Hens offense since intermission. Delaware's managed just 17 points in his second half, but defense has been a little rough lately too. Delaware mixing things up a bit here.
Yeah, going to the zone that we haven't seen them do, we haven't seen them a lot in this year. Maybe the coaches are looking to close off the penetration lanes and allow people time to get out on the shooters.
Bucknell misses the front end of the 1-1. Green grabs the rebound for UD as O'Brien could not convert at the stripe. Brown into the full court for Delaware. Bounce pass right wing Leone. Hand off to Brown. Brown playing with four fouls. Got away with a push off. Up top to Green. Green face the basket. Looks at her options. Gets a screen from Leone. Dribbling towards the left wing. Bucknell just will not let Green go to the basket off the bounce. There's always a second defender in her vicinity. Trying to go baseline. Three on the timer. Brown's got to get a shot off. Got the pass from Green. Got bumped as she went to the paint and got bailed out. Oh my, they call the foul with one left on the clock. Brown had no shot of getting a shot released. Big break for UD as Joy Caracciolo will return. And a crowd loves to see that. It looked like Caracciolo had suffered a serious injury. She's back about 6 or 7 minutes of gameplay later. They said you hope it was just one of those things where maybe it was more frightened than anything else. First free throw good for Brown, so she'll get one more. And by the way, not a coincidence that Delaware started to struggle almost immediately upon Caracciolo's exit. So perhaps her return can be a big assistance as the second free throw good. 50-46, Delaware back to within four. Five on the floor, Green, Brown in the backcourt. Jardine the swing player, Caracciolo with the four, Leone the five. Leone outside, guarding Dotson as Delaware back into a man-to-man defensively. Trying to go to work off the bounce to Boer, challenging Caracciolo, who tied her up. Arrow stays with Bucknell, but how about that defense from Joy? Moving her feet, knee seems all right. So the inbound comes baseline left, 11 on the timer. Bucknell 50, Delaware 46. Looking to get it inbounds here is McGurk. Finds near corner, DeBoer drives right by Leone, but can't finish. Craig the rebound, and then hammered by Steph Leone on the putback try. So it'll be two free throws coming here for Tyler Craig. Big contact from Leone. Wasn't going to give up anything easy, but fourth foul on Leone and the 18th foul on UD.
And in that defensive possession, we saw the Hens went back to man and man. The rotation on the help side was a little bit late when Steph Leone got beat.
First free throw is good, so Craig will get one more. 78% free throw shooter. She's now 3 of 3 for the game. The lead back to 5 for Bucknell, 51-46. 6:44 remaining in the second half. Craig bends the knees, lets it fly, and connects. So a 6-point Bucknell lead. Delaware with Caracciolo back in, see if that gets the offense moving a tad smoother. Brown into the forecourt playing with four. Bounce pass to Jardine. Jardine lobs to nobody, but Caracciolo chases it down. Boy, does Delaware look out of sorts offensively. Up top to Green. Green to the right wing. Crossover towards the lane, outside to Lyon. Left wing to Brown. Brown to the foul line. Shake and bake, lob inside Lyon. Finishes with the right hand. Almost a lob there from Brown to Lyon.
Offensive breakdown right there for the Hens, but Erica Brown making a very good decision to take the ball to the basket and create for a teammate.
Entry feed, left block, inside, working DeBoer, kicks it outside, three, wouldn't go for O'Brien, offensive rebound Dodson, and Bucknell will reset. Delaware got the stop, couldn't grab the board, that's a killer. Got to dig in again, down four with 5:48 to go. Up top, errant pass, good catch by Dodson on the left wing. Feeding to Craig, top of the circle. She'll dribble right side. Chest pass to McGirt. Foul line right. Into the corner, Craig. Her feet tipped out of bounds by a rotating Brown. And Jardine got a hand on it as well. Meanwhile, the two scorers back in. Not expected to be scorers, but they have been today. Sierra Jones and Jackie Klotz return. Out goes O'Brien and Craig. Seven to shoot. Got to get a hand in the face of Klotz. She's killed Delaware. 17 points on 9 shots from the field. The inbound goes to Klotz, and she hits from in the lane. Actually, the inbound went first to DeBoer, who found Klotz, and it's 54-48. Delaware has no answer for Klotz right now. 5:20 and ticking. Jardine with it right wing. Cross-court feed to Caracciolo. She feeds to Brown, foul line left. Brown to Green, no spacing for Delaware. Right with Lyons, who's gonna be open, but then Lyons' defender came off on her. Here's a crossover move and tangling of the feet. Delaware gets bailed out with a foul call. Looked like inside, Courtney Green tripped over the foot of Sierra Jones. I don't think Jones stuck her foot out, but they called the foul against Bucknell. They actually gave it to DeBoer, who didn't seem to be in the area. Then Green misses the front end of the one-and-one. Not much going right for UD. Jones the rebound, brings it up. Under 5 to play. Right wing with the basketball, Dodson. Up top, her feet goes to DeBoer. Around the perimeter to McGirt. McGirt dribbling on the wing left side. Up top. And a timeout called by Bucknell. The feed went to Jackie Klotz. 4:44 left of the second half. 11 left on the shot clock. Delaware down 54-48. Two timeouts left for the Bison. Big possession here. Boy, a three-possession game would feel like a big deficit the way Delaware's offense has struggled today.
Yeah, and right now we're seeing Bucknell is posting up Jackie Klotz anymore. We're not seeing her outside the three. And Erica Brown is on her right now defensively. That's a height difference that we talked about. So the help defense is absolutely going to need to come. We've seen her just now in this last possession. Bucknell missed her. She had Erica Brown sealed, and there was no help defense. So right now, the Hens really need to watch Jackie Klotz now on the inside.
Bucknell, you really have to admire the way they space the floor. They make it awful tough for the help side to be there.
They do.
The inbound will come with 11 on the timer. Far sideline in front of the Bucknell bench. It goes to McGirt. McGirt dribbles top of the key. Down to the right wing. Feeds it to Jones. Open three. Left wing triple. In and out. High arcer that just would not fall. Rebound Delaware. Hens dodge a bullet there. Green into the forecourt. Screen from Lyon. Near corner. Looking for some help. Got to get an inside touch. Everything around the perimeter right now. Brown gets it right wing. Brown crossing over into the lane, floats it, front rim no. Caracciolo offensive board is tied up. Arrow will keep it with Delaware. 4:17 left. Gets down by 6. How do you get it inside? That's the question right now for the Delaware coaching staff. The inbound on the lob to Green outside, top of the circle. Now dribbling foul line right towards the corner, weaving back to the elbow. Left wing feed to Lyon, around the perimeter to Jardine. Jardine working inside, hand checked, is fouled, and he'll head to the stripe for a 1-1.
Foul number 21.
And Jardine, 7 of 8 from the stripe this season. She's a good foul shooter.
And for the Hens right now, we're seeing a lot of dribbling, a lot of standing around and dribbling. They need to attack the basket, which we're seeing some players do, but attack and get other people involved. They need to start that ball movement that we saw earlier on in the game.
Stagnant offense right now, you're right, from Delaware. First free throw, though, good. Hens chipping away. It's down to five. 54-49. Men's, women's doubleheader. Hens fans looking for a win. Avoiding the sweep, men lost earlier 66-53 to Delaware State. Jardine hits a pair, and a deficit at four for Delaware. 54-50, the Bucknell lead. Hens hoping for a stop. Jones turning the corner off a high screen, stopped at the foul line by Jardine. Elevates it, just barely hits the front of the rim. It goes out of bounds off Bucknell. Back to Delaware when we return. Timeout on the floor, 3:55 left. It's been a slugfest, and Delaware tried to throw the last punch. They trail Bucknell 54-50. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOP.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
I know what it takes to win a championship. The fire burns real. My teammates and I are motivated. And now it's our time. Experience it.
.355 to go in the second half. Bucknell leading Delaware by a score of 54-50. The Hens have been trying to scrap and claw their way back in this one. Bucknell has been solid defensively. Delaware has had issues in the half court, but has started to draw some fouls and doing some damage at the line. Green top of the circle with it for UD. Operating in the forecourt left wing dish to Jardine. She circles to the top of the key. Inside of Leon, trying to back down. Now turnaround jumper, in and out. Rebound Bucknell. DeBoer grabbing the board. Outlets at four. Dotson on the right wing for the Bison. Up top to feed to DeBoer. Got away with a carry. Left wing feed to Craig. Craig directing traffic. Pass tipped by Delaware, but then run down by Dotson. Dotson needs some help. Finds Jones outside. Head fake out the defender in the air. Goes straight to the 10 and lays it in. And a lead back to six with just over 3 minutes to play. Here's Brown the other direction. Erica Brown playing with four fouls. Top of the circle. Left wing feed to Green. Green in the corner to Jardine. Somebody's going to have to hit a shot. Jardine inside. Caracciolo turn and face. Spinning. Got the seal and the layup. Banks it home. What a move. 56-52. 2 3/4 minutes to play. Dotson top of the circle. Left wing. Klotz around the perimeter. Jones right wing to Klotz. Klotz walks. Jab, step, move, the pivot, turns it over. Big possession here for Delaware, back to within four with 2:35 left. McGurk will return, Klotz out for the Bison. Delaware's done a bit better job on Klotz here these last couple possessions.
And what a job by Erica Brown right there, forcing her to put the ball on the floor. We haven't seen her do that a lot today. First time she does it, she walks.
Green, right wing from Brown. Looking inside for Caracciolo, can't find the angle. Instead, on the wing, to the foul line. Spinning, outside, corner to Caracciolo. Jab step, back to Green, 12 to shoot. Got a pick, Green contorts to the lane, got fouled. And he'll head to the stripe for a pair. Well, how'd she do that? No angle whatsoever. Faked left, spun right, into contact, and had enough strength to get it to the 10. And we'll shoot a pair.
Courtney Green.
Boy, they are making Courtney Green work for everything, though, aren't they?
They are.
Just multiple bodies flying her direction. First free throw, good. She'll get one more. Lead down to three for Bucknell. Clutch returning for the Bison. McGurk out as they're going to go defense for offense. Saw a lot of that end stages of the first half. 2:14 to go, second half. Green, second free throw, good. 56-54. Here comes Bucknell, the crowd standing in some portions of the Carpenter Center, trying to root their team onto a stop. Dodson, foul line left, up top clock. Right wing feed to Craig. Craig driving, help came, forced an off balance runner that wouldn't go. Craig tipped the rebound. Leon batted it. It ends up in the hands of Bucknell. Then it's ripped free from her by Green, and a foul called on Bucknell. Claire DeMore had it stripped away from her by Green. Dove to the floor to try to get it back and tackled Courtney Green by the shoestrings. It looked like a rugby scrum, but Delaware uses the toughness and Green will shoot a pair.
What a game by Courtney Green, finding any way to keep this Delaware team in the game.
All kinds of effort from this scrappy Blue Hen bunch. First free throw, good. And now Courtney Green can tie it if she connects on this one. 1:53 remaining in the second half. Green with 15 for Delaware. Brown and Jardine also have 15, but now Green has 16, and we are tied. Hens have played much better defensively of late. Craig, right wing to Klotz, Brown all over her. Turns the corner off a pick, jump shot wouldn't go. Weak side rebound, Jardine. Well, Bucknell got away with a moving pick, but Delaware still contested the jumper, and Jardine forced the one and done. Here's Brown, Delaware looking for the lead, 90 seconds left. Jardine handing it off to Green, just in front of us on the left wing. Crossover move towards the lane, floats it to Caracciolo, over to Leon, baseline jumper, rattled out. Rebound Bucknell. DeBoer pulled it down in traffic. Good look from Leon. Touched every part of the rim but wouldn't fall. Timeout Bucknell. They have one left. Tied at 56 with 70 seconds to play from the Carpenter Center in New Orleans. What a game this has been. Not all that pretty, but boy, if you love effort, you've loved this one. Both teams laying on the line. And Delaware, tip of the cap, getting back in this one. Not much going right. It's been all effort.
Yeah, and that just goes to show the Hens are finding a way to win this game. Any way that you can pull this game out. Courtney Green getting to the basket, getting to the free throw line, getting the points that Delaware needs to crawl back in here.
The Hens, 9 offensive rebounds. Bucknell only 8. Delaware shooting 38% for the floor. Bucknell, 40%. The Hens made a bunch of threes early. They were 5 for their first 8. They're 1 of their last 8, though, from long range. So it's Bucknell ball, 23 to shoot, 1:10 to go out of their call timeout. Inbound goes to McGurk in the forecourt, dribbling right wing. Hedging a high screen is Leon. Forces her outside. Left wing dish goes over to Jones. Jones off the high screen. Good hedge from Leon. Forcing one up. Jones back rim. No. Rebound is loose. Sprawling after it, Brown. And she dribbles out of a pile with the ball. What an effort by Brown. 50 seconds to go. Delaware ball in a tie game. Hens only 1 timeout left. Tina Martin wants it now. Sensing the importance of this possession, obviously. Comes with 44 and 3/10 seconds remaining. Tied at 56. And so when you take your last time out, that stresses. You need a Buccaneer in the worst way.
Absolutely. And the way Courtney Green has been playing right now, finding a way, like we said, to get to the basket, to get to the free throw line. She's getting other people involved. Put the ball in her hands, make something happen.
Hens on a 6-0 run over the last 2 minutes and 6 seconds. It was a 56-50 game. And remember, Bucknell had a front end of a 1-1 that they missed. From there, the Hens have dug in defensively. And the Bison is not getting many good looks. Erica Brown, really have to credit what she has done defensively. Klotz has worn Delaware out over the course of the afternoon. But Brown got put on her and has really stepped up and has given her no space to operate whatsoever.
Yeah, and she really did shut her down, allowing the Hens to get back in this game. She forced her to put the ball on the floor, which she hasn't done all afternoon. She forced that walk. Those little things that she was listening to the coaching staff to do, and that was perfect execution by Erica Brown.
A couple good hedges on the screens from Leon there, too, forcing them away from the basket rather than letting them turn the court.
Yeah.
That was an adjustment. At the half, they switched how they were playing the ball screens. Nice one for UD. So now 20 on the timer, 44 and 3/10 seconds to go. The inbound goes to Brown. She's joined on the floor by Green, Jardine, Leon, and Caracciolo. Green dribbling left wing towards the near corner. Picks up her bounce. Left wing to Jardine. Top of the circle. Right wing chest pass to Brown. 70 shoot. Brown turning the corner into the lane. Bump. No call. Floats it up. No good off the rim. Rebound out of bounds off Bucknell. Went off the leg of DeBoer. It'll be Hens ball. Shot clock off. 25 and 2/10 left. No timeouts for Delaware. Got to hold for one here if you're UD. Looking to get it in. To Green near corner. She'll circle it outside. You go to Brown or Green here?
Green.
Brown moving it outside. She'll hold to start. Winding clock. You don't want to go until there's less than 10 left. Martin holding up her hand now says go. Brown attacking off the bounce. Turns the corner. Floats it up. Too strong. Offensive board. Caracciolo. Hands lead. 5 seconds to go. Into the lane, timeout Bucknell with 1.7 to go. Oh man, the Bison forced a shot up. They were panicking. Good poise as Claire DeBoer called timeout. But how about Joy Caracciolo? She looked injured in a major way early in the second half. Returns, gets the offensive board, and the follow that gives the Hens the lead with 1.7 left.
Two big baskets Joyce had in this comeback for the Hens right now.
Delaware coaching staff trying to get the officials' attention to find out where they're going to throw the ball in.
That's actually a very good question. And if they're going to add time to the clock here too.
I wouldn't think there would be any time because the official called the timeout from behind the play, but I think they are talking about exactly that.
There was more time on the clock when the coach from Bucknell was signaling for the timeout.
It didn't seem like initially they gave the timeout. They pointed at the player, but you're right, they are going to go over and look. So we'll see. Right now, 1.7. What do you think, 2.5, somewhere in that neighborhood?
At least around 2.
That drastically changes. If you get 2 or more seconds, you get the ball in, head fake or a dribble or two to free yourself up.
And also where they're going to put the ball, too. That looked like what Coach Malcolm was coming out to see, where the ball was going to be placed.
I think they signaled near sideline, just inside the midcourt stripe, right between the midcourt line and the three-point arc. They're over at the monitor now, checking time left. Switch on everything here if you're UD, but
absolutely,
make sure you stay back near the basket.
Klotz and Jones right now, the Hens have to make sure they are locked in on those two players.
Don't foul either, because A, Delaware over the limit, 1-1 on any foul in a two-point game, and B, with around 2 seconds to go, likelihood Bucknell's taking a three. You don't want to put them at the stripe with a chance to win the game. You don't want to foul in the act. Tina Martin. Drawing out the play defensively on the whiteboard. This is where all that time spent watching film pays off. This early in the season, though, there's not that large sample size. Bucknell did play one tight game early this season, but for the most part, they haven't had a lot of endgame situations that Delaware can draw them. But sometimes you go back multiple years to see what a coach likes to do in a certain situation.
Yeah, but in this type of situation, just in general, at the end of a game, a close game like this, you go back to your principles and your fundamentals, what the coaching staff has been talking about. They go through these types of situations in practice, so they should be ready to handle this right now.
Well, they're still over at the monitor checking exactly how much time left on the clock. And this is critical. It's 2.5 at the end of the world for Delaware. Anything more than that, it's kind of switches everything the coaching staff is talking about. The principles are still there, but it really changes how you defend it.
Yeah, this is just enough to get a shot in your hands and get it off. A little bit more, that's the possibility for a rebound and a putback.
Klotz has that tall frame. Brown has been guarding her and doing a good job. But she's got, as we discussed earlier, 5-inch advantage in terms of height. So even if Brown is all over giving her no space, she will be able to rise over top and at least get the shot off.
Yeah.
Do you run a second big body her direction? Because if it's around 2 seconds, there's probably not time for that extra pass, right?
Yeah.
What's the magic number there? 2.5 for the chance for one extra feed after the inbound?
I would say right around 2.5 for that rebound and putback, a possibility for that.
So we'll see 2-1, 2.1. is the exact number that goes on the clock. So 2.1 seconds. Now that they have the clock, they'll give the teams a little extra stretch here to talk strategy and let them know how much time's left. And then here it is. Five of the four defensively for Delaware. Brown, Green, Jardine, Leon, Caracciolo. Inbound will come from McGurk near sideline. 2.1 to go. Delaware by two. McGurk looking. No timeouts. Gets it in. Clyde straightaway triple for the win. No! Front rim! Delaware wins! They hold on 58-56, scoring the final 8 points of the game. And what a finish it was. Delaware over 500 for the first time this season. 4-3 on the year. Oh man, Klotz had a look at that one, didn't she?
She did. That was a very, very clean look. The Hens got lucky there, just bounced off the front of the rim.
We will take a break when we come back. The American Spirit post-game show as Delaware beats Bucknell 58-56.